Good afternoon and welcome to the Pratt Center in Brookville, New York for today's East Coast Conference Game of the Week featuring the CW Post Pioneers and the University of the District of Columbia Firebirds. Alongside Chris Granozio, I'm Steve Zardellian. Great to have you here with us for the final East Coast Conference game of the season.
Pioneers with a 5-2 lead, floater baseline, score it and one. And there's a look at exactly what Felicia Joyner can do. She gets it on the wing, a quick explosive move to the paint. Cross-court pass eventually gets into the hands of Junior, and she buries the wing three. Hammond two-on-one, tries to go behind the back and messed it up totally. Now a five-on-one for CW Post. Williams at the offensive end, score it, and the foul against Anderson. Chop into the lead some more. Abola right to the paint, throws it up and gets the friendly roll.
Very nice play out of the Galloway, New Jersey native.
Three on the wing for Junior, too strong. Outlet goes for Joyner, one-on-one. Takes it right to the hoop on Abola. She's got no chance to stop Joyner on that move. Then comes Joyner. Brittingham can match her for speed and does so. Nice catch in the paint by Kopp, and she ends up scoring. The tempo was slowed a bit in the last couple of minutes, but an errant pass by Kopp goes right to Brittingham, who blows down the court and lays it in.
We're here with Deirdre Moore, and Coach, your team leads 34-30. It's a back-and-forth kind of game. Pretty much could go either way.
Yeah, I mean, UDC is a good team. You know, they only have four losses all year. We're trying to slow the game down, but at the same time, we want to run. So it's just trying to be, you know, careful with the ball, pretty much.
Alexis Peters, sophomore, is having a great first half for you. She has 13 points, and where are the threes coming from?
She's been working really hard with one of my assistant coaches, Asima Thompson. You know, she's been in the gym on the shooting machine. They've kind of changed her release point. Doing a couple of different things with a shot, and she's playing with confidence, so it's working for her.
And Nicolette Marchiniak is doing a fantastic job on the glass, as usual, a real beast for you.
But we're better when she's on the floor, whether it's shots for herself or shots for her teammates. And, you know, you probably won't see Felicia Joyner or Nicolette Marchiniak come out this game too many more times.
Okay, and lastly, what do you have to do to pull this one out the whole last 20 minutes?
You got to take care of the ball. We have to take care of the ball. I haven't seen the stats yet, but I would imagine at least 8 to 10 of UDC's 30 points are in transition. We just can't have those kind of transition turnovers. I'll take the travels and the throwing it out of bounds, dead ball turnovers. We just can't have the transition turnovers.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck to the second
Thank
half.
You.
Coach, your team is right in the thick of things, but offensive rebounding is killing your club. 11-0 in second chance points. Could you address that at halftime?
Yes, we talked about it in the locker room. Right now it's 28-17, and they just beating us on the boards. So right now, you know, we got to put together a complete team effort, rebound the basketball, and continue to locate their shooters. They're doing a good job of spreading the floor. And then on the defensive end, they're doing a good job of taking Lauren Brittingham away. They're trying to double team her, so we got to find some other people to step their game up so we can close this gap in the second half.
We've seen the best and the worst of Brittingham at this point. Sometimes she gets a little too high in throttle for her own good, maybe sometimes go high in the back passes, leading to a 5-0 on break. But we also see her brilliant passes down low and hitting three-point shots. Obviously, you want to see the better Brittingham show up in the second half.
Definitely. We talked in the locker room. I just told her, settle down and just make the simple pass. Make the simple pass, and we'll be fine in the second half. Told her, continue to attack the basket, and then try to find those shooters. Janelle Dream has to step up, and Jasmine Rich in the second half and knock down some shots for us.
And defensively, your club is so good at mixing up your D and also with the pressure. Do you expect that to wear them down a little bit?
Hopefully. The last game that we played, and we end up wearing them down in the second half. So the second half, we're going to continue to press them full court. And then in the half court, we just try to trap on the sideline.
Coach Lester Butler, Jr., thank you very much. Good luck second half.
Underneath it, missed by Griffin. Now in transition, it's Joyner. Misses the drive. Marciniak on the glass, puts it in.
Corrals the rebound.
Nice touch pass by Joyner ahead for Marciniak for two. That's a sweet move. Doing a whole lot of dribbling. Finally gets away from a couple of Firebirds in the front court. Peters, nice touch pass to Marciniak, who lays it in. It was a 42-40 game when Lutz and Caggiano hit threes. Marciniak inside scores again. They just have no answer for Nicolette Marciniak, who's got 20 in this game. With a big victory, 78-60 over District of Columbia.
Also a leading scorer in the game with 24 points. Not a bad senior day, huh?
Not a bad senior day. It's for Felicia, though. Felicia and Kat at the end of the day. That's what it's about.
You have the two seniors. Now, tell us about what you do on the glass. I mean, you're just a hardworking player. Despite the nose injury and the face mask, you just continue to play really, really well.
Well, one thing that Coach D always told us was there's no success without adversity. And like my motivation is to be relentless on the glass. It's not scoring, it's to help my teammates get open. And if we play like a team, nobody can beat us. Not Bentley, not number one team in the nation, not the 25 team in the nation, nobody.
Now you're locked under the four seed now, as St. Thomas Aquinas already won today. You're going to play New York Tech here, so you will have at least one more home game. Tell us what you think about your next door neighbors and what that matchup's going to mean for your team.
They're a good team. Like Sierra Baker, she's a strong competitor, but I like our chances at home. You know, we play really well together and we share the ball well, and I don't think anybody can beat us. So we just got to come out with that kind of a mentality.
Hard-nosed player with a great mentality from Brooklyn. Nicolette Marchiniak, back to you guys.
Thanks very much, Chris, and she's not pulling any punches there. Marchiniak telling us exactly what she thinks, and this is going to be one dangerous four seed as we see her hugging her coach on the baseline. 9 rebounds for Marchiniak. Her team out-rebounded UDC by 11, but they really laid it on early to blow this game open. Let's send it back to Chris, who's with Deirdre Moore.
Once again with Deirdre Moore, and Coach, your team put together a 27-6 blitz in the middle of the second half. It was a 42-40 game. What turned the tide for you?
Honestly, I mean, if you watch baseball, they always say baseball's a game of inches, and that's what I felt like it was out here today. Some of those passes we were making could have been turnovers that DC turns into layups, but they fell in our direction. We were able to get some layups against their trapping and doubling.
Nicolette Marchiniak, what a job for her off the glass, and also a game-high 24 points. How much has she meant to your club?
You know what? I told Nicolette before the game started, she could be the X factor today. She has that ability. She is having the best year of her career here at Pulse. She's averaging the double-double. The first time we played them, she had broken her nose. So she had an hour and a half practice underneath the belt. And today, she's able to practice. You know, the kid works so hard. She's in the gym, you know, getting extra workouts in. Just happy to see it show up for her.
Now you head into the playoffs. New York Tech is next. You're familiar with them. They're right down the road. Your thoughts on Wednesday's semifinal, quarterfinal?
Nikki Giovatolo, Sierra Baker, you know, Johnson. New York Tech is going to one-on-one us all day long. We got to stay solid on defense, board the defensive glass, and try to get out and run.
Congrats on a great senior day.
Thank you.